Monsters exist, but they are too few in numbers to be truly dangerous. More dangerous are the common men, the functionaries ready to believe and to act without asking any questions. Primo Levi. What would it take for you to become a monster? To look down at the men and women around you and feel nothing but disgust. History is full of warning signs, and the darker the warning, the less likely we are to come to terms with the horrors of humanity, of what we are capable of. The darkest moments in human history tell tales of bravery, resistance, and community. But history also tells tales of hell on earth, of truly despicable things humans can do to one another. And in the middle of heroics and atrocities stands you. Understanding your capacity for good gives you a goal to work towards, while truly understanding your capacity for evil, it gives a light to what you should be fearful of. And our jobs as musicians is to be merchants of emotion, and ignoring the dark side of humanity, it does not allow people to come to terms with their own dark side. By controlling your darker thoughts, they can be used as a force to make the world better. But ignoring the worst parts of yourself, it allows the dark aspects of you to manifest in truly horrific ways. Inside all of us hides traits we are not proud of, traits that are repressed, that we hide away from, and ignore. Only by shining a light on the dark aspects of your personality are you able to control them, and if you ignore them, you fall into the dark side. The negative aspects of one's personality is called the shadow, and this was brought to light by Carl Jung, a psychiatrist throughout the 1900s. The shadow is the traits you choose to ignore in yourself, or just can't see at all, and the best way to get a glimpse at the darker side of yourself is by observing the negative thoughts you have towards others. By recognizing what other people do that makes you upset, you'll be able to start to recognize those traits in yourself. The shadow can't be seen directly, but by looking for negative stimuli in your life, you can start to control the shadow and use it as a tool for compassion. Like looking at a shadow on the wall, you can only see the effects of a shadow and not the shadow directly. One way I like to think of the shadow is as if it was a low frequency oscillator, and those tones affect everything above it. It is not something you can hear directly, but an LFO changes different parameters in music. The same thought can be applied to the shadow, where if you've not come to terms with built up anger or jealousy, it will manifest in a variety of ways. From lashing at those around you in a fit of anger, to blaming those that care for you for your own shortcomings. So let's take a look at this chord progression. Let's start adding in some LFOs to represent some negative aspects of my personality. Here's one for jealousy, another for my deep-rooted ability to get obsessed with things, and another for a fear of failure. With all these LFOs running in the background, it makes this chord progression sound like an absolute mess. And just as if we aren't aware of inaudible frequencies in our music, it can have a negative impact on the song. If we aren't aware of the negative feelings we have, it can ruin everything we do. But by looking for the effects of the darker sides of ourselves, we can start to pinpoint what we can work on, and eventually incorporate it to make us better. What does it mean to incorporate the shadow, though? Why should we be so willing to examine and allow the dark aspects of ourselves into our lives? It makes more sense on the surface to become the best and most loving version of yourself without any negative qualities. But that isn't true, and we are going to figure out why. First, by recognizing your own shortcomings, it allows you to have compassion for those around you that exhibit those same traits. Rather than look at someone filled with road rage with a feeling of disgust or anger, you can have compassion for someone that allows his or her emotions get control of them so easily, to the point where they can't think clearly. Secondly, coming to terms with the darker aspects of yourself allows you to defend your ideas, yourself, your family, or your friends. If you are confident in your beliefs, you must state them even when it isn't easy to do so. It took courage to speak out against racism during the Civil Rights era. It took courage to speak out against the National Socialist Party in the 1920s. And that courage comes from a place of accepting conflict as a part of your life. And to accept conflict, you have to accept the darker parts of yourself. And lastly, the darker aspects of your personality can be used to make you better. For example, addiction isn't always bad. Being addicted to something that helps you, your friends, your family, and community is beneficial for everyone. Music is an addiction. It requires hours of studying and practicing every day to be valuable to the people around you. But if you aren't aware of that addiction, it causes you to be a detriment to yourself and those around you. And by choosing to only focus on music and not take care of yourself, or your responsibilities, this addiction can ruin your life as well as the lives of the people around you. The amount of life lessons studying music can give you is astounding, and the parallels between the shadow and music don't just stop at low frequency oscillators. The idea of the shadow within frequencies can be seen within the overtone and undertone series. The overtone series can be heard when a note is played. As a note rings out, there are actually multiple frequencies ringing to create that note. These frequencies are called the overtone series. The overtone series corresponds to a frequency getting multiplied repeatedly. For example, if we play a C and then multiply that frequency by 2, we get another C. Then if we multiply that original frequency by 3, we'll get a G, and so on. The first 5 notes of the overtone series creates a happy C major chord. To create the undertone series, instead of multiplying a frequency, we divide it. So if we take C again, then divide that original frequency by 2, we get another C. Then divide it by 3, we get an F, then C, and then A flat. These first 5 notes create a darker F minor chord. This corresponds to going down the darker side of the circle of fifths, where if we go right, we get brighter sounding chords and key centers, but if we go left, we get darker chords and key centers. We can also incorporate the shadows of our personalities into the music by looking at the shadows of chords. By learning about negative harmony, we can apply the darker version of a chord to get a darker sound. Negative harmony has been brought to popularity by Jacob Collier, and before that, Ernst Levy in the book, A Theory of Harmony. There are 2 ways of approaching negative harmony. Either chromatically or modally. Chromatically, if we're in the key of A-flat major, we find the halfway point between A-flat, the root, and E-flat, the perfect fifth, and flip notes around that halfway point. So that would be B and C. So if we have a B-flat major chord, B-flat would flip around to D-flat, D would become A, and F would become G-flat, making a G-flat sus2. Now, creating negative harmony modally, we take a look at the relationships between notes, and apply those same relationships going backwards starting from the fifth. Here's a table of A-flat Ionian. If we copy those relationships starting from the fifth, E-flat, we get E-flat Phrygian. So let's apply that modal negative harmony to that chord progression and see where it takes us. This chord progression is in the key of A-flat and has a chord progression of 1, 3, 2, 5 sus 4, 5 major, 3, 1, 5. Let's replace the 5 chord with its darker counterpoint using negative harmony. Instead of getting a 5-1 progression, we get a 4-1 progression, which relates back to the circle of fifths and the overtone and undertone series. Where the overtone series goes up to create a 5 major chord, the undertone series goes down to create a 4 minor chord. But let's go deeper than just using one chord borrowed from A-flat's negative harmony. Let's switch all the chords and see what changes. A-flat major becomes A-flat minor, C minor becomes F-flat major, B-flat major becomes G-flat major, E-flat sus4 becomes D-flat sus2, E-flat major becomes D-flat minor, C minor becomes F-flat major, and it ends with A-flat major becoming A-flat minor. And we just made this chord progression represent some psychology from Carl Jung. By learning to understand and incorporate the darker sides of your personality, you can lead a more fulfilling life. From having empathy for those who find themselves in worse spots than you, to having the confidence to back up your opinions, or using some of the negative aspects of your personality to make you a better person. Choosing to look into your actions and discover the person you really are is a painful process, but it's worthwhile. And our jobs as merchants of emotions is to show the true range of love and grief around us. I hope I gave you some tools today that allows you to explore the darker sides of yourself and how to apply that to your music.